Madam Chair. Welcome to the committee, Secretary DeVos. Yesterday was the 20th anniversary of the Thurston High School shooting in Oregon, where a 15-year-old student killed his parents and then walked into the high school with guns underneath his trench coat, killed two students, and wounded 25. That community is still grieving. You said the Commission on School Safety recommendations will be out by year end. It's only May. Students today are telling me that they walk into a classroom and the first thing they do is look for where they can hide and how they can escape. I want to join Ranking Member Scott and others who are calling for hearings, but on behalf of Alexandria and all the students who are marching for their lives, will you please expedite the work of the commission?
We are working very quickly to do the work of the commission, and as I said in my opening statement, I have directed my department to do everything within the law to support the schools as requested under the omnibus bill that expands some of the funding for, and we encourage schools to take advantage of that opportunity today.
I hope we see meaningful recommendations soon. With regard to higher education, states play an active role in protecting their residents from predatory, unfair, and deceptive practices. And over the last few years, states have recognized a need to take action regarding student loan servicers, requiring them to be licensed and enforcing borrower protections. The department recently published an interpretation saying these states are preempted by federal law, which would, of course, severely restrict the ability of states to protect their residents. In your opinion, are these servicers doing a good job? And as someone who talks about states' rights, isn't the interpretation inconsistent with your position on states' rights?
Thanks for that question. Federal student aid is a federal program, and as such, has federal oversight attendant to that. We believe it's important for that to be consistent, and if we had 50 different states with 50 different approaches to oversight, it would be a very confusing and convoluted process. As long as federal student aid is a federal program, we believe the federal level has the appropriate oversight responsibility.
And Secretary DeVos, that response is quite concerning, and I urge you to read the bipartisan letter, which I would like to, with unanimous consent, to place into the record. It's a letter that I wrote with Representatives Bishop, Polis, and Love, stating that you should please reconsider your decision. Scores of states' attorney generals, our governors, and state banking regulators all agree that states should be able to protect their own residents. Will you commit to sending a timely response to that letter?
Yes, I will.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Now, the Every Student Succeeds Act. Congress recognized the value of the Student Support and Academic Enrichment Grant Program. We funded the program at $1.1 billion for fiscal year 2018. Recently, you stated in the House Appropriations hearing that the program is worth revisiting given the areas of education it supports and the flexibility it provides to school districts, and I agree with that. So, Secretary DeVos, one of your key responsibilities as a cabinet secretary is to advise the president. Unfortunately, this program has been zeroed out not once but twice in the president's proposed budgets. So will you commit that you will advocate for this program and its funding to the president so he does not again target it for elimination?
I commit that we are advocating for a budget that builds in a lot of flexibility to the state and local level, and that funds can be used in a broad array of activities and programs. They have to be, I believe, states and local communities are best equipped to make the decisions about what's right for their students in their under their purview. And so we will continue to advocate for that kind of flexibility to the state level.
And again, this is a program that has bipartisan support, and I encourage robust funding. Following up on Representative Polis's question, just recently LGBT students in Oregon were bullied and forced to read the Bible at a public high school in rural Oregon. Is your Office of Civil Rights investigating?
If a complaint is brought to our attention, we will certainly look at it and see if that falls under the purview of our office.
Thank you. And finally, you submitted a story in your written testimony about Shirley and her daughter. Her daughter was afraid of being bullied in a neighborhood school, so the mom was trying to earn money for her to go to private school. I was looking for the next page of your testimony where you say that you went to that school in her neighborhood and you spoke with educators and administrators and families. Maybe they need better anti-bullying program. Maybe their classes are too crowded. Maybe there's lead in the water. Maybe they need wraparound services for students in poverty. If your responsibility is to all students, why isn't that part of your story?
It was a very touching story about Shirley, who has been working extra jobs in order to afford the right place for her child to go to school. And I cite it as an example of the desire of all parents to have their child go and learn in an environment that works for them.
I do encourage you to go visit that school that you were talking about and find out why that daughter was afraid, because most of the students in this country attend public schools. We should be focusing, and as someone who has a responsibility for all students, you should be focusing also not just on one student, but all of the students who attend that school, and try to determine what we can do to help all of the students. Thank you, and I yield back.